I'm here with Emily and Chris Huskins. I know you're running an ecological farm, Chris and Emily, and you're going to tell us all about it because you've got a crowdfunding campaign going on during the COVID crisis. So tell us a bit about what crowdfunding campaign's about.
Yeah, so the crowdfunding campaign is helping us to keep this going. We have there's a lot of words before the word farm, organic, community, ecological farm, and it all comes from the fact that there's a brilliant company called the Ecological Land Cooperative who buy big parcels of land and then split them up into smaller and make the land accessible to people like us who couldn't necessarily afford buying big parcels of land and dealing with planning authorities. And that's what's happened here in Arlington in East Sussex. That is exactly why we set it up. However, this the last few months haven't been easy, so we moved on in November. We know November through January were the wettest months on record in Sussex. Then we had the storms. Cara wiped out quite a lot of infrastructure we had built within the last 2 months. And now we find ourselves in the middle of a global pandemic. So it's not been the easiest time to set up a farm.
People want veg boxes at the moment, don't they? Your services are exactly what the customer wants at this moment in time.
People are crying out for this. They're crying out for local good produce. And it's highlighted the sort of problems with some of the food system we have in the UK already.
So tell us a bit about the crowdfunding campaign and how people can get involved.
But what we'd like to make clear is that this isn't a crowdfunder to allow us to have a farm. What we're actually looking to fund is the community aspects. And there's sort of three sides of that. One is to allow us to build facilities and tools so that we can continue, once the lockdown is lifted, to have the likes of local groups, volunteers, open days for schools and that sort of thing happen on the farm. Another is to be able to create a nature haven on the farm. So we've set out a quarter of the land we have to be a nature reserve, which is an expansion of a large nature-driven pond, extending of a piece of woodland and just sort of a peaceful, real nature-driven area so that we're not just taking from the environment and nature and the climate crisis, and we're actually trying to give that back and share it with nature. And the other bit is to, really be able to continue to grow food on this local level. Because if there aren't farms like this doing it, then we're going to have this breakdown again and again and again if things like this happen.
Yeah.
We've also got one of our other real, like, community-driven aims is we are planning to put in community gardens, which is dedicated areas on the farm where everything grown in those areas will go to food banks and local projects in Brighton and Eastbourne to provide like local homegrown veg for people who can't get it themselves.
Brilliant. We'll leave it there. Chris, Emily, all the best with the campaign and the farm, and we'll catch up again soon. Thanks for talking to us today. Thanks.
Thank you.